Dear students, we were exploring the home ribbon in Microsoft Word, and until now we have learned about clipboard group. And today within the home ribbon we will be focusing on the font group. And the topics which we will be covering in today's module are font families and font names, bold, italic and underline, strike through, subscript and superscript, text effects, text highlight color, font color, increase, decrease font size and change case. So let's start. So we were on this document, and this is the font group which has the fonts which are available and the font sizes. So let's try to explore it. For example, if I want to change the font of this, for example, paragraph, I have selected this paragraph and I have selected this font families, and there are many font families. For example, if I want to change the font to this, I have clicked on this font and you can see that the previous font which was like this has been now changed to like this. And you can increase the size, for example, from here. So you can see that I have gone to 20 size. So this means that this size, the size of the selected content has been raised to the 20 and others has been the same which was already available. This was 10. So if I want to go back, you know that I can click on Control Z. Then I can also increase the font size with this. For example, I have selected this content, and if I click on this once, you can notice that the size of font is increased by 1. So previously it was 10 and now it has raised to 11, 12, 13, 14 and so on. And then you can decrease the size similarly. So we have learned font families, font size and how to increase and decrease. And if you want to clear all of the formatting which you have done on this document by opening this document now, you can click on this and all of the formatting which we have performed have gone away. You have seen. Then you can, let's go to the original document, and then you can do bold. If you want to highlight, for example, this is the heading. Let's do it bold and a little bit more size. Then you can also do it italic. And you can also have underline. You have seen that there is no underline even after I have clicked because I have not selected the text. So let's select first and then perform the underline. Then you can see this strike through. For example, if you want to write this abstract and you want to put strike through or a line, a cutting line onto this word, you can have this option. So let's do it in a simple document. For example, you have said that your birthday time 4 p.m. to 6 p.m. So for example, you have previously mentioned this time and now your time has changed. So you can select this. You can put strike through and then you can say now it is from 5, the strike through is coming because it is selected. So now it's 5 p.m. to 6 p.m. So you can cut any of the content from your document if you want. Then there is an option of subscript and superscript. So in mathematics you might have seen, sometime we say X and for example I, and that I need to be put downward as a subscript to X of I. So if I can show you with a little bit more font, so you can see that this is subscript. And if you want to put it over as like X raised to power 2, so put 2 over here, select it, and click on this button, that will become x raised to power 2, y raised to power 2 or whatever. So we have learned all of these things. Then there is a style available. So let's say again, I'm going to the original size of the world. So I say this is ITC course, and there are different styles which are available, text effects. For example, you can select like this one after selecting, of course. So you can see if I make it a little bit bigger, so you can see the effect downward. Similarly, you can make it like this one. So such kind of formatting you can apply using the text effects and typography. Then you can also use this text highlight color, like you can use it. You can change the font foreground color. So this is for the text highlight and this is for the foreground, which is the color of the writing. Then there is only one thing which is left, that is change case. So for example, you have written this document, and let's move to the original one. And you have noticed that I need to write all of this paragraph in the capital alphabets. So this doesn't mean that you need to retype all of the paragraph again. You can select that paragraph and you can go over here and you can say uppercase. So this means all of the paragraph will instantly shift it to the uppercase. So all of the letters, alphabets have been changed to the capital alphabets. Similarly, you can also perform sentence case, which means that first character of the sentence will be capital and others will be smaller. Then you can also say lowercase, so all of the letters are in lower alphabets. And then capitalize each character of the word. So you can say C from the citations and P from the play and P from the pivotal have been capitalized. And similarly, you can also perform the toggle case, which means if something has been written in capital, that will be shifted towards smaller alphabets and smaller will be shifted towards capital. So let's do it. So now you can see the citation C, which was capital, now it is smaller in smaller alphabets, and other letters which were previously smaller, now they have been shifted to capital alphabets. Let's go to the original case. So we have explored the font group in the home ribbon very extensively. Let's summarize today's module. We have experimented with font group and we have performed very informative and attractive task, from changing the font, font color, and number of text graphics and typographies and change cases. So all of these are the very elementary kind of functionalities which you need to do on daily basis while using the word processing softwares.